So you're always hearing that you're supposed to have a personal brand and that brand is going to carry your business forward. So in this video, we're going to be looking at exactly what is a personal brand, how do you create one from scratch, and most importantly, how do you monetize it? We're going to begin right now. So my name is Ainsley Stewart and welcome to my channel. If this is your first time on, welcome to you. Special welcome to you, and if you're a returning subscriber as well. On this channel, we look at tips, tools, and strategies to grow a profitable business online, as well as entrepreneurship and a sprinkling of motivation here and there to keep your mind right, to keep you in that right mindset, to be able to achieve the lifestyle that you and your family can be happy about. If that sounds like something you'd be interested in, definitely hit the subscribe button, click the notification bell so you can join the family so that I can send you a notice every time I upload a new video on this channel, which is pretty regular. So be sure to join the family. Leave comments down below. I respond to as much comments as I can, if not all. And I'd love to hear what you have going on, what business you're growing, and as well as how I can help or how I can add value to what you have going on. So without any further delay, let's dive straight into the content. So like I said, we all know that we're supposed to have a personal brand, and that personal brand is what actually carries you forward in your business. So what we're gonna have is a two-part video series. In part one, we're gonna look at what exactly is a personal brand. We're gonna look at some do's and don'ts to your personal brand. In part two, we're gonna look at how, step by step, how to monetize that personal brand. So let's begin with what a personal brand is not. All right, we're gonna look at building a personal brand from scratch. Let's look at what a personal brand is not. A personal brand is not your logo. It's not your tagline. It's not your color palette. And all these other pretty things that a lot of people are mistakenly believing that is their personal brand. Now, even so, your personal brand is basically the perception that your audience have of you every time they hear your name or your brand name. It also includes your body of work, as well as your reputation that you have in the marketplace in your specific industry or niche. One thing to note is that everybody has a personal brand. Everybody has a reputation that follows them, a reputation that even goes before them. Every time their audience hears their name, or potential clients or customers hear their name, there is an idea or perception. What type of perception? Is this a brand known for integrity, known for great delivery? Is this a brand known for its professional image? That is basically what a personal brand is. Now, that being said, because there are a lot of personal brands out there, there is a lot of noise. No matter what industry, no matter what niche you're in or niche you're in, right, there is a lot of noise. There are a lot of people competing for your particular audience. So what we're going to be looking at in this series is, how do you stand out? How do you prevent your name from being obscure or even buried in the graveyard of brands that nobody could remember, nobody knows? Because the last thing you want to happen is for your name to be obscure. And like I said, you don't want to end up in that graveyard of brand names that would have been from the past that are clearly forgotten and nobody remembered. So let's begin with some do's on creating a personal brand from scratch. Some do's. The first do: spend time on your core values. Now, you gotta pull together your core values. So what I would recommend is that you pull together three words that would encapsulate what your brand stands for, what is the value that you add to the market, and what you bring and what you offer to your audience, what your content is gonna be around. So for example, my three core values are authenticity. So basically, I want my brand name to reflect my authentic self. I want people to know exactly who I am when I put out a body of work, or my body of work that already exists. I want people to know that I'm coming straight. I'm not cutting corners. I'm not being inauthentic. Also, another word that encapsulates my personal brand is integrity. I want to be someone of integrity. I remember that one time ago, I actually was misled through a brand name. And ever since that, I always valued integrity. And what I bring to the marketplace, I want it to be always perceived as being full of integrity. Also, lastly, what I want my personal brand to be known for is servanthood. Now, servanthood is definitely not the most sexy topic. If this video was titled How to Be a Servant, I know that I would not get no likes, no shares, but that's okay. I value servanthood. How do I serve the market? What do I bring to the marketplace? Being someone who is pretty spiritual, I believe in servanthood and giving of yourself to the marketplace in an authentic and a way full of integrity. So that is just an example of pulling three words together that encapsulate your brand. So you take some time, spend some time pulling together your core values in those three words, and that is the beginning of creating your personal brand. Next tip is be clear and consistent on what your message is and who it is for. A lot of brands fail with this, and this is why they end up in obscurity, because of the amount of noise there is in all of these marketplaces. If you don't come crystal clear, you're gonna confuse your audience. People don't have time to sit there and figure out what your audience is about. So you definitely have to ring true and be crystal clear on your messaging and who your messaging is for. Tip number three, stand for something. If you don't stand for something, then definitely your personal brand would not be seen, you would remain obscure, and you would not be remembered. You wouldn't create that legacy that it is possible for your brand to create. People need to be clear as to where you stand with those people that are attracted to whatever you stand for, or they agree with what you stand for. They would definitely follow you. So be sure to stand for something. Next tip, be sure that your brand carries through the entire transaction and beyond. So one time I purchased something from quite a reputable brand. When it came to contacting their support, I was really, really disappointed, right? Knowing the type of brand that this was, I really expected more. And for your personal brand, you want your messaging, your branding, and your values to carry straight through. So even though upfront their brand may have been very popular, very well known, right, and very and perceived to be very solid, basically when it came to the end, right, support and end user support, etc., it was really, really disappointing. And you don't want your brand to be upfront that people are attracted to it, and then when it comes to the end of the transaction, after you receive the money or whatever you are giving in exchange, whatever you are receiving for the value that you are bringing to the marketplace, that you just cast them aside and they are no longer needed. So you want to be sure that your brand carries through the entire transaction and even beyond. The next tip is be sure to have a brand story. People follow stories, people love stories. And one of the things that a lot of corporate businesses aren't able to capitalize on, which personal brands do and influencers do, is that ability to have a story, a very personalized story that a lot of people can relate to and follow, right? And that is why personal brands as well as influencers, they are kind of taking over the markets, and because people can relate, people can resonate with, and that is definitely something that you definitely want to have. So have a story. Most basic storylines have a character. They have some type of trouble that they would have gone through, and they would then have some way that they overcame. And that is the basic storyline. So if you have some type of story that tells of where you were and what brought you to where you are and why you are bringing this value, certain values to the market, etc., then definitely people, you're gonna be a larger audience, and it's going to be, and let's be serious, you are going to make a lot of money. So let's look at some don't. Number one, don't be afraid to be polarizing. So as said before, once you stand for something, you're going to be polarizing, but that's okay. Who resonates with what you stand for is either they love you or they hate you. There's no in-between. The in-betweens, they are the ones who get buried. They are the ones who end up in the graveyard. So don't be afraid to be polarizing. Next tip is don't be inconsistent. If you put out content or you add value inconsistently, you are gonna be forgotten. So the thing, the most important thing is to be sure to be consistent. Stay away from inconsistency. Find some way to schedule the way that you add value to the marketplace, especially through adding content, which we'll speak about in video 2. So by the way, if you're just joining, be sure to check out part 2, which we're going to be looking at how to monetize your personal brand. So don't be inconsistent. Next tip is don't focus on the little things. Don't sweat the little things. So as mentioned before, your brand is not your logo, your color palette, your tagline, and your bumpers and your videos, front and end. These things, even though they are important, now don't get me wrong, Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that they are not important, but they are the little things. They will come with time. So as you grow your audience will actually guide you as to what your tagline will be because of the people that you are attracting. You will know the people that, if they are the type of people you want to attract, right? If you need to change your tagline to attract different people, or the logo, or etc. So don't sweat the little things. Don't overthink it. Next tip, don't be afraid to exclude some people. So if you're polarizing and if you stand for something, then definitely some people are gonna like you, some people aren't gonna like you, but that's okay. The people that do like you, you know, there's this concept called the 1,000 true fans, right, that I read about some time ago. I can't remember the author's name, right? 1,000 true fans. And what the concept is basically that you only need 1,000 true fans to make it big in any industry, to build the lifestyle that you want to have for you and your family, right? Because 1,000 true fans are the ones that, and giving the example of, let's say, artist, right? Let's say Rihanna, right? The people, Rihanna's true fans are the ones that would buy every single CD. They would fly over the country to get to one of her concerts. They would line up outside to get tickets in the cold. Or if she's launching a new clothing line, they would have most of them. So those are the true fans, that the people that the fans that would buy anything from you, that they would be looking out and maybe even asking you, messaging you, when are you bringing out something else? I want to get what you have to offer. So those are the 1,000 true fans. So the people that fall away from on the side that don't like you, that's okay. That's what a personal brand does. And that is how you're going to be seen in all of this noise. That's how you're going to ring through all of the noise. Next tip, don't be someone else. Now, a lot of people, you build your personal brand by imitating other personal brands or influencers, and that definitely is not going to be your personal brand, and it isn't going to work. It's not going to work, right? The other tip is don't be too attached to your personal brand, because as you grow, because it's a personal brand, as you grow personally, things will change. So all of that is why I mentioned do not pay too much attention to these small things, because those things can be changed quickly, right? Your brand, it changes over time, it evolves over time. As you change, as you grow, things will get different. You may realize that this is not the type of audience that you want to attract, and you may have to change things around. So don't be too attached to your personal brand. Now be sure to watch the part 2 next. It's going to be in the cards above or in the description below. So see you on the next video.